Hello friends, today we are going to make a very nice and fancy effect of water, where we'll have water flowing on these rocks, and after flowing on these rocks the water will come, and here we'll have a pond area where the water will be filling up. So as you can see here that I have these boulders already created in my viewport. There's nothing special, nothing fancy, just have these kind of boulders created by yourself. This kind of boulders you can create and then texture it accordingly, like I have textured the boulders something like this. So just create your boulders and texture them. So now we start making our water effect animation. So when you have created your boulders, create them in different shapes and different sizes, and after creating them, as you can see, I have placed these rocks like the steps. You can see I have these two steps. We will create the effect like the water is flowing over these rocks, then falls down, then again flows over these rocks and then falls down here, and here we will have our pond. So water will be filling the pond at here. So after creating your boulders, place them like this. Next, we start making our water. So for making the water, we'll use a polygon plane, and then for the waves and the motion in the water, we will use bump map. We will do that using textures. So let's get started. So for the water, I will create a polygon plane. We have this polygon plane. I will make the X-ray mode on so we can see. So if I show from the top, I will position my plane something like here, and maybe I will scale it, and then I will move it forward. So here we will have our water flowing, and this area will be our pond. So after creating your polygon plane, increase some more mesh there. So for the subdivision width and height, I will make them 100. We want quite much polygons, and after making them 100, we will place them. So place your polygon plane just a little above your rocks. They should not be penetrating in the starting. So after placing the polygon, now we will convert this polygon plane into a soft body. So we will go in the dynamics menu set, go in the soft body and say create soft body, reset everything and creation option, make soft and say create. So when we convert any object into a soft body, the object will get particles for each vertex. So now it has been converted into soft body. And if I show you in the outliner that we have our polyplane, and under the polyplane we have our soft body particles. So now we will animate these particles to animate our plane. So I will select the particles and will go in the fields, and first I will apply gravity to the particles, and now I will come in the time slider and I will increase some more frames and make sure that you are playing every frame. So now let's see what do we have. So as you can see, when we play, our polygon plane is falling down. So we want that the polygon plane should rest on these rocks. So for that, we'll have to create a connection between our rocks and the particles. Our all the rocks are inside this group. And if you can see, we have boulder 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. So now we will make connection between these all boulders and your particles. So first select your particles and then control click on your rock. And then we'll go in the particles, and there we have make collide. I will go in the options and first reset everything, and now in the options we have resilience. Resilience is for the bounce. I do not want that the particle should be bouncing on the rocks, so I will just make the resilience to 0, and I will have a high friction because I want that the particle should rest on our rock, and then say create. So now one connection has been created between the particle and the boulder 12. We will do same thing for all these boulders. So how many boulders you have in your scene, make a connection between all of them. So I will select my particle again and will select our next boulder. And again in the particles, I will go in the make collide option box. And we can just say apply. So connection has been created. Then I will control click on the boulder 1. And then I will control click on the next boulder and apply. So like that, you deselect your previous boulder and select your next boulder and make a connection between all the rocks and your particles. So I will keep doing that until I have connected all my rocks with my particles. Deselect your previous one, then select your next one and apply. and then we have the boulder one last and say apply. So now we have a connection between all these boulders and our particles. And now let's play and see what do we have. If I turn off the X-ray mode, and I will also hide the grid. So we can see we have our soft body particles and they are resting on our rocks. So we want something this kind of geometry. And I will also do one thing to have more volume in the shape. So for that I will go on the frame 1, I will select the particles and I will go in the soft and rigid bodies. And there we have create springs. I will go in the options, reset everything. So for the creation method, I will change it to wireframe, and wire walk length, I will change it to 2. So just make these two changes and say create. It will take some time to create, let him create. So now our spring has been created in the soft body. This is our spring. So all the particles are now connected with the spring. So here is our spring created. And now if you see in the outliner, there we have our spring. So I do not want to see my spring in the viewport. So select your spring and make the visibility to off. And for the spring, there we have one attribute, stiffness. I will change the stiffness to 150. And now we play and see what do we have. So now you can see we are getting some more soft look in our geometry. This is happening because of the spring. I will go on frame 1 again and play. So I want some more height for this step. So we can play frame by frame and it will deform like that. So I want something like this, or maybe one frame more. So I want this height for my geometry. So when you are done, we will select our geometry and now I will create a duplicate of it. So select your water geometry and go in the edit and say duplicate. So now we have got two planes, polyplane 1 and polyplane 2. And this is our duplicated water geometry. And if you see inside that, we have the soft body particles also. So we have got two planes. So I will need this one. I do not want the particles in my second geometry, so I will just delete it. And now we'll call the new duplicate water. Water geometry. And I do not need my soft body plane now, so I will just delete it. I will delete the gravity and the spring also. I do not need them, so just delete them. So now we have our boulders and we have our new deformed geometry. This is our water geometry and we'll have this geometry for our water. So in this geometry, first thing you can notice that we have penetration between the rocks and our water geometry. So first we'll control that. So I want that I should have some thickness for the water also. I will select the water and I will just move it up little. You can see I moved it up something like this, maybe little more up. If I show you in the X-ray mode, so by moving the geometry up, we will achieve two things. First, we will have thickness for the water. Here you can see this is our water geometry and under that we have our rocks. So now we'll have some thickness for the water and as well as we can remove the penetration also. Now you can see we have removed quite much of the penetration. Somewhere we still have the penetration, so we will directly control that moving our vertex. So select your polygon plane, we'll go in the vertex mode and now I will directly remove them. So here we have some penetration. I will select the vertex there and I will press B for the soft selection and then I will move it and remove the penetration. So just select your vertex wherever you have the penetration and move them. So it doesn't matter, you can just directly deform your geometry. So here I have penetration and I will move it up here, little bit here. So wherever you have got penetration, we will control that and move this one here. So wherever you have the penetration, just move your vertex. Here we have some penetration, so I will move it up. Sideways, I will not show this part in my render view, so it doesn't matter. I will just leave that. So here we have our water geometry, which will be flowing like that. This is our water geometry and under that we have the rocks. So If I show you from the front, we can see that the water is falling here. So here we are getting some unnatural deformation. So I will control that. I want that it should be falling straight. So for that, I will directly just deform the geometry. So we'll select our polygon plane. We'll go in the polygons. And I will take the sculpt geometry tool, go in the option box. And there you have operation. I want to push this area. So I will select this operation. Maybe I will increase the brush size and I will push that area little back. It is getting deformation. Don't worry for that. We'll control it. And after pulling it, I will now smooth that. So now we'll take the operation smooth and smooth it little. And here I will pull it. So we can get the geometry back, and I think we have quite much placement. So I will reduce the value. It will pull less. So I will remove the penetration like that, and after removing, I will smooth it. Undo it. So here, and I will smooth this portion also. Here we are getting penetration, so smooth it, and I think we should push it and then smooth little push here with reduced value, push it. So now our water will flow and it will come like it will come here like this. And then same thing I will do for this part also. So again you can press Y to get your previous tool, and I will make the X-ray off, and we will push this portion also. So like that, we have changed our geometry. So now we are done with our geometry. Next, we'll start making the waves in our water. So we'll achieve that using the textures. For that, I will select the water geometry. We'll go in the rendering and I will apply a bin to this geometry. So we'll go in the bin tab. First, I will change the color. So any color you want for your water, you just give it. I want to show it the water in the forest. So I will have a greenish look. So maybe something like this. So there we have transparency. As we know that water is 100% transparent fluid, so I will have quite much transparency in the water. I will have it around 90%, so something like 0.9. So after having the transparency, let's render our scene so we can see what do we have. So I will render this scene and see. So here you can see that we have our water which is shining on the rocks. When we are rendering, I think we should have lights also. Let's make some lights. So I will create an ambient light, move it up, maybe here. For the intensity I will have 0.7, and I will create one more light, spotlight, and we'll look through selected and position it like that. And then I will have some penumbra angle here, so maybe something like this. And for the intensity of our spotlight, I will have it to 2. Now we'll come back in our perspective and let's have our view set. Maybe I will see this pass. And I will save this view. So you can click on the bookmark to save. And let's render. So now we are getting this. Let's come back in our blend and have some more changes. So we'll go in the blend and first we'll create our waves. So we are going to create the ripples and waves using bump mapping. For that I will click on the checker box so we can get our textures, and I will create the waves using fractal. So click on fractal. So for the bump depth I will change the value to 0.15. We want small ripples in our water, and let's see what do we have. So when you render, now you can see that we are getting this kind of bump deformation in our geometry. So how much height you want for your water, you control from here. If I reduce it to maybe 0.05, and I will save this scene to compare and render. So now you can see we are getting less height for the water waves. This is our previous, this is our new one. So I think 0.15 was good. So just change it to 0.15. And now we'll come in the fractal. So currently our pattern is static. So we will get static water. This is good for only still images. If you want to move your ripples, for that we'll have to animate our texture. Let's animate our texture. So for that we'll come down in the fractal and you can see that we have one option for animated. So I will check it on and now we will animate our texture. So we'll come on frame 1 and first we have to set one thing, go in the preferences and go in the animation and make sure that you are having linear in and out tangents and then save. And now we'll come on frame 1 and we'll animate the animated attribute. So here we have animated option and there you have the time attribute. So we will animate it. If I change the value in the time attribute, you just notice this pattern. If I change it to 0.5, it is getting changed. So it means that when we get change in our pattern, same change we'll get in our water ripples also. So we'll animate this attribute. So on frame 1, I will have it to 0. Right click in the attribute and say set key and then we'll come on our last frame. I'm getting some problems in my view, so we'll come on last frame and then come back again in the time attribute. I will change it to 0.15. so like that we will animate our pattern. So we will get animation in our ripples also. So now when you click on the input button, we'll go in the place 2D texture node. So from here also we can move the texture. So first we have the repeat UV options. So for them I will change them to 0.4 and this one to 0.4. So if I render to show you, now we'll get this kind of pattern in our waves. So I want that the wave should be longer when they are falling on the rocks. So for that I will change the value in the U to 0.8. I will have the just double length of the waves in U from the V. So now if I save this one and render a new scene, so we can see the difference. So this is our previous where we have the equal UV and there we have in the V we have 0.4, in the U we have 0.8. So we are getting longer waves, you can see, and they are giving us more natural look. And then we'll come in the translate frame attribute. From here we move our texture. So to show you what is going on, I will have some changes just for time being. So we'll go in the hyper shade and this is the blend which is applied in our water. Select the blend, we'll click on the input and output connections. So in the work area it will show you all the nodes connected to your blend. I want to see the fractal noise as a color in my blend. So middle mouse click on the fractal, move it and leave it on our blend and then choose color from the list. So now in the color attribute we do not have color but we have the fractal texture. I will get the transparency back and now you can see in the color of our water we are having this fractal texture. This is just for time being, only to show you what is going on. We will go in the fractal, place 2D texture node, and we know that the fractal texture is applied for the waves. So for animating the waves we have attribute translate frame. So if I change the value, you can see what we are getting. So as you can see, when I'm increasing the value in translate frame U, our waves are moving from left to right. And if I change it to negative, they will just go reverse. So we want that the water should be flowing from this direction to this direction. So that is V. So if I increase the value, our waves are moving to that side. But I want they should be coming from here to here. So it is our negative value. So when the pattern in our fractal is moving, same motion we will get in our waves also. So just think that these are all your waves when you render. So our waves will be moving from this direction to this direction. So now we'll animate this value. So let's get it back to 0. We'll go on frame 1. I will right click on this attribute and say set key. And then we'll go all the way to frame 500. I will change the value to 0.8. So like that we'll animate our texture, so they will come from this direction to this direction. So now we have set our waves animation, so we'll get our color back. So let's select the water plane, right click on the color, you can say break connection, and then we'll get our green color back. I will get my transparency back, so 0.9. I did all these things so I can show you that what is going on. And now if we render, so we see these kind of waves, and now we know that these waves are animated also, and they are coming from this direction to this direction. To show you, I will come on frame 1 and render one scene. We'll save this one, and I will come on some later frames, maybe 193, and render again. And now if you see our previous render and new render, so we can see we are getting different waves pattern. It means that our water is now animated. So when you render your whole sequence, you will get water flowing from this direction to this direction. And now we are done with the animation of the texture. Let's add some more detail in the water. So for that I will come in the plane, and in the downside we have the specular values. So I will make the specular smaller, so reduce the value. I will reduce the specular roll off also, and let's render. Maybe I will save this scene so we can compare. So now we have reduced the speculation quite less. For more detailed render in the water, I will go in the render settings, will go in the Maya software tab, and there you have ray tracing, make it on. And maybe for the reflection value I will increase it to 6, so it will give us more shiny water. So let's save this one and render, and now we can see we are getting more reflective and shiny water. This is because of the ray tracing. This is our previous one without ray tracing, and this is our new one with ray tracing. And one thing also I would like to do, I will select the spotlight, and in the shadow I will choose use ray trace shadow. So turn your shadow on, and now if you see we'll have more depth in our scene. So now when we have shadow on, we can see we are getting shadow here, and we are getting some more depth in our scene. This is without shadow and this is with shadow. So now we have set up our water. Let's come back to plane, and now as we know that water is very much seen because of the reflection it has. So now we'll control the reflectivity. Leave the reflectivity to 0.5. So for the reflected color, I will not use a color. Instead, I will use a texture. Let me show you what texture I will use. So this is the texture I am going to use for the reflection in the water. You can get these kind of textures on the internet for free. Just search them and you can find the reflection maps. Or you can create your own in Photoshop. So we'll come back in the reflected color attribute. Click on this checker box, and for the reflection I will use an environment texture. So click on the environment texture. There you will find environment sphere. Click on this one. So we'll use our image in the environment sphere. So for the image, again click on the checker box, use file, and I will now call my image. So here our image is applied in the environment sphere. So let's render and see what difference we have now. I will save this file and render. So now when we turn the reflection to on, we are getting more shiny and reflective look in the water. This is our previous and this is our now. This is without reflectivity and this is with reflectivity. I think we have the reflectivity a little much, so we'll select our object and maybe reflectivity I will reduce it to 0.35. So now we are getting the reflectivity with our texture map, and we are getting this kind of water ripples. Now as we know that our water is flowing from this direction to this direction, but here at this area we are having very plain look. If we see, this is our water plane, and at this area we are getting just a single plane, and there is no motion at this part also, only the texture will be flowing. So I want that we have some motion in the geometry also, so we'll get more realistic look. And here also I want to add some more noise, and we will do that in the second part of this video. So please click on the link for the second part and we'll continue there.